DHS and the Coast Guard, through Force Design 2028, are prioritizing drone innovation, and they're consolidating all of the drone programs in the Coast Guard under one umbrella, which is the RAS PEO.
Part of rapid modernization and tomorrow's mission, integrating uncrewed systems of all types and multi-domains is a critical step. These tools are important for our operators to have the data that they need to do their job and keep up with our adversaries.
One of the great benefits of the drones is the extended flight time and the live video coverage allows the Coast Guard operators to go through a lot of paperwork drills and processes that used to take a long time, but now we can get that done before the helicopter even takes off to execute a mission. The VBAT is a 160-pound fixed-wing drone. It's a push-motor aircraft with a vertical takeoff and landing capability.
Some of the big improvements VBAT has provided is being a bigger UAS platform. Payloads that they can carry for just camera detection allows us to zoom in, see exactly what's on board, how many people, what to expect.
The presence capability of UAS systems on board assets like Cutter Stone enhances our risk analysis really from the start to the finish, which helps us decide what actions we need to take while we're on target.
The biggest upgrade of the VBAT is the storage footprint. Because the VBAT can take off and land on its own, it does not require a separate catapult or landing mechanism, which really frees up a lot of valuable space on our cutters.
Robotics and autonomous systems are the rapid modernization that the Coast Guard's been after for a long time. This modern tool set is what our operators need to face the challenges of tomorrow's mission.